हेलो एवरीवन, एट एनी टाइम इफ आई एम नॉट ऑडिबल प्लीज जस्ट रेज अ हैंड, स्टॉप मी. ओके, सो आई विपुल, आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू द वेबिनार प्रैक्सिस बिजनेस स्कूल प्रेजेंट्स एएमए ओपन हाउस विद प्रैक्सिस डेटा साइंस स्टूडेंट्स. थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर टेकिंग योर टाइम एंड ज्वाइनिंग अस. फर्स्ट लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस माई सेल्फ. सो माई नेम इज विपुल महापात्र. I am a current student at postgraduate program in diploma science at Praxis Business School. Prior to Praxis, my educational qualifications are that I have done BTech in mining engineering from VNIT Nagpur and PGDM from IIM Shillong. Post that, I have worked in two organizations, one in Coal India Limited as a mining engineer and in Hindustan Copper Limited in the B2B sales department selling basic copper metal. While working at SCL, I was first introduced to the world of database, SQL, Oracle ERP. That's where I took an interest in all this data stuff. I got to work along with the IT department of our company. And from there on, I developed an interest. I asked my seniors and friends in analytics division, and they all advised me to go for a data science career. I looked at the various options, be it online or classroom, and Praxis was the obvious choice for me because of its full-time classroom course of a 9 months duration, and it has a great faculty, nice curriculum, large alumni base, and that's why I joined Praxis. My experience at Praxis has been very good, very enriching. I learned many concepts, be it machine learning, statistics, deep learning, tools and techniques like Python, R, SAS, SQL, all these stuffs. I am placed at Mahindra as a data scientist, where I will be starting my data science career and hoping to grow from a data science enthusiast to a thorough data science professional. That's all. Thank you. Now I ask Momita to introduce herself.
Hi guys. Am I audible, Vipul?
Yeah. Sir.
Okay. So, hi guys, I'm Momita Ghosh. I'm born and brought up in Mumbai. I have done my graduation in computer science from SK Somaya College, Mumbai. I got into Capgemini through campus placements, where I worked as a SAP consultant for 2 years. Other than working in SAP basis and security team, I was also part of the management reporting team, wherein I got the opportunity to work with business data, make reports, analyze the trend in data, and so on. This is what made me realize that I enjoy working on this more than the SAP part of the work. So I was basically working with Excel for the management team, but with today's new upcoming technologies, I wanted to learn the new tools in market and the different methods and practices to be an expert in this area. That's when I started my hunt for colleges in data science. I chose Praxis as it is one of the top colleges in India for its data science course. On researching about Praxis and talking to the alumni, I got to learn about their experienced faculty, a up-to-date data science curriculum, a classroom study, good placements, and networking. It being a 9-month course has an edge over other colleges. My experience in Praxis has been a roller coaster. In the start, it scared me to study with people who are 5 to 10 years elder to me with years of experience, but trust me, it turned out to be amazing. Not only I learned the concepts of data science, analytics, business approach, but also I got an opportunity to connect with and work with students from different parts of India. I have been part of placement committee, which helped me build my network. Praxis has cultural and sports events as well, which will keep you entertained in the hectic 9-month course. I was placed with ICICI Bank on day zero, one of the 16 companies that had come to recruit on that day. I was on the shortlist of IRIS, Colgate, Axis Bank, ICICI Bank, Mahindra, and SubPaisa. Today, I can proudly say that I have good knowledge to start my career in data science with ICICI Bank. Now, I hand it over to Soumya.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to our webinar. I am Soumya Srivastav. I have completed my engineering in electronics and communication branch. After that, I've joined Accenture and worked there for around 2 years as an ETL developer. Last year, I joined Praxis July batch, Bangalore campus, to pursue my post-graduation in data science. I have switched from IT to data science because I had a lot of interest in analyzing the data and exploring it and creating a story out of it. Also, I knew that this field has a lot of scope and this is one of the booming fields in the industry. So that's the reason I chose Praxis. Currently, I am working at Colgate-Palmolive as an associate analyst in analytics department. So that's it about me. Thank you. Now handing over to Kunal.
Yeah, thank you, Soumya. This is Kunal Bhardwaj. I am from July 2019 batch of Praxis Business School. I have done my BE in Electrical and Electronics from Thakral College of Technology in 2012. I have 6 years of experience in analytics, most of them as a visualization expert. Prior to joining this course, I was working with Cognizant and then ZS Associates. I have worked in various domains like finance, healthcare, and life science. I was working as a senior consultant in ZS, focusing mainly on providing analytical solutions to the clients. While working on those projects, I realized that there are a lot of unexplored advanced fields like ML and AI, which I can explore. I wanted to expand my experience in addition to analytics. Hence, I opted for a short full-time course in data science, where I can build a strong foundation of the concepts and then take it forward with the time. After reading reviews on Analytics India magazine, Quora, etc., and talking to a few of the alumni, I joined the course at Praxis Business School. Currently, I'm working in Deloitte as senior consultant. So, first of all, thanks a lot for your immense interest and sending us the questions. We have bucketed those questions as the proper heading. So we'll just go through them one by one. And then at the end, if you have any kind of questions that are left, we can take it forward. So I'll pass it on to Soumya to proceed forward.
Okay, so going on with the first category is what is data science? So many of you have asked us this question before, and that's where we have clubbed some of the similar questions into one bucket. So first one was, what is the difference between data analytics and data science? So as this question was asked by Jaydeep, data science is a huge field. So it contains from data mining to data pre-processing, data analysis, data visualization, then predicting on the past data, and then creating future scenarios, creating story out of it. So all these things comes under data science, while data analytics is part of the data science, which includes analyzing the pre-processed data and getting the insights out of it. So the next question was, what is data science and is it worth for an experienced CA to do this? And as I've answered earlier, what is data science? Talking about CA, yes, it is very much useful. There are a lot of applications in banking, financial services, and insurance. And it is a great combo. CA plus data science is always a great combo. So the next question was, is data science important for mechanical engineers? This question was asked by Harshal. Yes, it is important for everyone, actually. Loads of mechanical engineers were there in our batch. Data science is one of the fields which is used in every industry, in every domain, from media to fashion to politics, everywhere this is used. And many companies out there require domain knowledge plus data science knowledge. So having a mechanical background is not at all a problem. It is just an added advantage. So the next question was, what is data science and how it is related to mathematics? So data science requires a lot of logical thinking, and mathematics helps you think, understanding the backend of how the model works and creating the scenario, how the prediction is acquired. All this requires mathematics, and mathematics helps us explain it very clearly. So that's why it plays a very important role in data science. What is the future prospect of data science and how can data science help us in upcoming years? So as I've mentioned earlier, it is a field which is evolving, and it is going to continuously evolve as one of the most promising and in-demand career paths for all the skilled professionals out there. So yeah, it is one of the booming industry right now. Next, please. So these are the takeaways which I've answered earlier. Data science is the most basic term and can be defined as obtaining insights and information. then data analytics is something which comes under it. And yeah, it is evolving right now. So that's it from what is data science and difference between data science and data analytics. Next, please. So now handing over to Vipul.
It's Momita here. I'll be taking on this topic. So I'll be answering few of these questions, starting with what can I do to pursue a career in data science and take it forward in India, since presently growth in this field is not promised as much. This question is by Ritika Tiwari. Ritika, I would like you to know that data science is actually booming. It has emerged as an attractive career option for freshers as well as for experienced professionals. The demand for data engineers is very high in sectors like information technology, telecom, manufacturing, finance and insurance, retail and many more. It is mostly because just as the population is increasing and people are moving forward to the digital world, the size of data is also increasing. The size of data generating every single day is around 2.5 quintillion bytes, and as forecasted by scientists, the size of the data will reach around 163 zettabytes by 2025. It is actually said that data scientist is the sexiest job of the 21st century. Taking on to the next question, I want a career change from sales profile to analytics. Surely you can do so. We have classmates who have done that and seniors too. For example, Vipul himself is from sales background and he has been the topper of our class. You need to be just good with numbers and comfortable with technology. And hard work will be your key to success. Next question. What is the future scope and can I do part-time job because I'm working so, and is there any growth? So according to the report, in 2020, the job requirement for data science and analytics is projected to boom to by 364,000 opening to 2,720,000. So if you want to seriously build a career, we would suggest you to do a full-time course. It is a tough program and you need to get concepts right. Plus the campus placement programs helps a lot. Moving to the next question. Is this AI architecture related course? Not architecture related. It is actually a hardcore hands-on modeling and application to business problem solving. AI architecture would be more data engineering, where again Praxis has a full-time program starting in Bangalore soon. This next question is wishes for getting a chance for career transition in data science. Actually, it's great. You just need to join Praxis. The up-to-date curriculum of Praxis will surely help you build your career in data science. What are the opportunities to the fresher? It's same as it for the experienced people. Good to get into the data science early. Moving to the next slide. What are the requirements to be a data analyst and data scientist? As said before, you need to be good with numbers. Therefore, statistics and linear algebra is important. Other than that, you need to be comfortable with coding in Python and also query language such as SQL. And the most important requirement is you need to have a business solving attitude. How can we start up personal business and data science with friend circle? You need to learn the domain well, need to understand the applications and have a clear area of expertise that you can offer. Lots of startups are there in this area. Now I'll take up the last question. What are the various job fields that we can explore after data science? So some of the prominent data scientist job titles are data scientist, data analyst, business analyst, data analytics manager, consultant analytics, and all these profiles are actually offered during our campus recruitment process. The next slides will be presented by Kunal.
Yeah, thank you, Momita. So taking on the questions about the career, what are the career opportunities in data science? So under the umbrella of data, various career opportunities that can be explored. One is data visualization expert, data modeling expert, then risk analyst, which is for banking, like for a credit card or a home loans, whether they will default or not, which basically runs the business. So these are the some of the opportunities that basically help the businesses to run. Also, there you can also go to AI part, where you will be AI engineer or data modeler, which also helps a lot. And in the coming time, that will be a booming thing. So I think according to career opportunity, there's lot to get. Rekha has asked, pay scale of the people can get after doing the data science. So just to quote it from LinkedIn, one of the LinkedIn research, for a fresher, it is around 6.5, starting from 6.5. And for a experienced of 10 plus years, that will be around 50 lakhs. So the salary remains in between them according to your skill set and how you improve them going forward. So Yash has asked, what is the salary package of data science can get? So it is, as stated earlier, it depends on the year of experience and the domain knowledge that you will have. And going forward, as you gain the experience, the package grows exponentially. Amit and Giti has asked, like, what is the salary growth? So compared to any other field, and as this is a booming technology in the current scenario, the salary growth is much better than any other fields. So it is generally, if you are going for a hike, so it will, when you are changing, it might be more than like 100% also in a year. Then Ipshita has asked, like, what is the difference between data science jobs, data analyst and business analyst? So just to throw some light on that, generally data analyst job is collecting the data and understanding it and just reporting them to the higher management. Rather than business analyst work is not moreover like just to understand the business and deliver the all the I would say deliver the key insights to the business. But a data science person would be something who would be able to predict the future, and generally they will be predicting developing the models and then predicting how these sales numbers will go on. So coming to the next slide, yeah, so the first question is, due to the current pandemic, my college is currently organizing my placements. So how can I apply by my own to the data analyst position? So frankly speaking, applying to the data analyst position and getting it will be a tough call as per the current scenario. Because generally all the companies would have a look, like if you have a certification or if you have any kind of prior experience in the same field, because it's all about like how you are able to tackle the scenarios involved in them. So I would suggest, like, if you do a course on that, or if you have a prior experience, then I think you can directly apply to them. Some project ideas which I can do to add to my CV later. So you can have a domain knowledge and you can get the domain knowledge and then learn the data science technologies. And then there are a lot of project ideas which we have done in our capstone also, which was capstone projects, which were based on NLPs and then computer visions. Then some of the projects were marketing research. So there are ample amount of projects. You can also refer Kaggle, which is a great platform to get the ideas and all, because there you will be able to see the competitions that run on the world level. So what are the challenges faced while shifting from sales background to data science? So we to answer this, we have Vipul, who was in the sales prior to joining this data science course, and he has excelled pretty well in the data science, and currently he will be joining Mahindra as data scientist. So as a fresher, we have what is the chance of getting placement in top MNCs? This question is asked by Soumya. So I'll just quote one example from my own batch, that is Akhil. So he was from mechanical background and he was a fresher. And he got selected in IDFC Bank with the almost one of the highest package from Praxis. So if you study hard and if you give your 100%, I don't think so that being a fresher or being from a non-technical background will ever matter. You should just have a learning capability and you should have a good thinking ability on that. Is there any coding knowledge required for data science program? So I would say, generally, as it is moreover like a business related and moreover on the business terms, so coding knowledge is not that much required, but if you have it, that will be an edge over the others. So passing it to Vipul to cover the next section, background and suitability.
Thank you, Kunal.
Yes.
Yeah, moving on to the next section. Can we proceed to the background stability part? Yeah. So here we have the first question, like, how far is this course beneficial for me as I am completely new to it? Secondly, how much exposure will one get after the completion of this course in terms of company placements? Lastly, is this right decision to step into data science and that too in Praxis, not other B school? If Praxis, then why? I think this question is asked by Divya Baheta. Yeah, this course is extremely beneficial. If you want to, if you are intent in pursuing a data science career, absolutely, this is the right time. You should jump into it. You should definitely join Praxis given its many advantages. Like it has a full-time course, classroom course, and not like other online courses. In my personal opinion, I think a classroom course has a much to give you. You can gain much more from a full-time classroom course than online course. And they are in this field from the past 9 years. They have a large alumni base, which will help you a lot. They are support. They have placement support. So it is the company placement, it is all taken care of. So definitely. Like the next question is, I have completed honors in mathematics from Calcutta University. Is there any opportunity for me or my types of students in data science for further study? Yeah, of course. We have many friends who have done, we are basically from mathematics and statistics background, like Mayank is from statistics background. They do quite well here in this data science field, and they are at the top of their class also. They have gained a lot of knowledge, lot of concepts. What will be next question is, what will be your advice to 8 years experience in automotive industry who is looking to build career in analytics industry considering all risk factors of family, job, and current COVID-19 scenario? Yes, of course, this is a difficult time, but we understand. But if you are actually willing, you are actually interested in building a career in analytics industry and to be specific data science, then you must join this course. This will help you a lot. The early you join, the better it is, because there are lots of demand, as already told by my friend Momita. You have definitely coming from an automotive industry background with 8+ years experience. For example, me, I am from a mining plus sales background, which is very non-technical, similar to you, having 5+ years of experience, but it doesn't matter. It gets a level playing field. As long as you are willing to put in the effort, put in hard work, you will be there. You can do it. It is irrespective of which field you come in from, you will succeed if you put hard effort into. The next question, my background doesn't have any relevance with analytics, machine learning, AI aspects of the same. Can I still get admission course offered? If yes, what are the chances of mine getting successful in the field? As already told, irrespective of the field you come in from, because data science is such a field that it is a culmination of so to say three different areas. First is the technical know-how. So people come from the IT background, computer science background. The second is mathematical and statistic background. So people come in from that side also. And the third is the domain knowledge. That is the business area from where. So most of people come from that side also, be it commerce students, from sales area. So this is a field where people from all very varied different fields come in. They learn the concepts, gain skills, and do very well in this field. That's all. Next slide, please. The question is how to pursue in data analytics. As a commerce graduate with no background of programming or coding, should I opt for PGP in data science? Yes, of course you can pursue PGP in data science. Take example, my own example. I had no prior background of coding or programming whatsoever. Still, I learned all the necessary things of coding in Python as well as R, even in SQL right here. I put in extra effort. Now I am quite confident of myself that I can code very well the machine learning concepts and do well in this field. Next question. I read mathematics and statistics in school and college and have done fairly well in them. Yes, very well. You will be having a statistic background is quite advantageous, because I think the bedrock of the data science is built upon the statistics, so it will help a lot. Next question. I am basically a highway engineer who took a break from career to restart the career with data science. How should I be prepared? Do I need to have how data works in his business? Is this the right time to enter the field as recession is happening? So again, even if you are a highway engineer, yes, you can enter in this field of data science. You can gain skills and do well. Yes. As you go on developing your skills and gaining experience, you need to have the knowledge of how data works in each business, because ultimately data science is used to solve business problems in the end. So that is very necessary. And is it the right time to enter the field as recession is happening? Yes, the early on you enter in this field, the good for you, because anyways, post this period, we know this is a difficult time, but relatively speaking, compared to other fields, this field of data science is still promising. Hiring is still continuing on. As of now, company Vedanta is still hiring, its process is going on. Our friend here, Momita and Kunal, will tell you more about that. And last question here is, I completed BE Mechanical Engineering in Data Science. Is easy for us or not? This is neither easy for you nor difficult for you. If you are willing to put in effort, learn the basic concepts, it will help you. It is a level playing field for everyone. So here we end with the questions of background suitability. Now we move on to the next section, that is about the program details. I would like to invite Kunal and Momita to take up the next section, please.
So I'll take up this slide, Momita here. I want to know about the difficulty level of the program. So data science is not rocket science. It is not difficult to learn, but it requires a lot of hard work and determination. The learning and understanding you'll take from this course is excellent. It will help you in future when you get into jobs and start working. Coming to the next question, average placement package, programming language needed, is cybersecurity linked to data science? The average package that we got for this batch, for the July batch, was 9.8 lakhs. Programming language needed will be Python, R, SAS, And in addition to that, query language such as SQL. In Praxis, the data science and the cybersecurity are completely different courses. Next question. JEE and MHT CET marks considered for admission in Mumbai Engineering College. Explain the details. So your profile is definitely considered in the admission of Praxis, but JEE marks is not considered. Your CAT, ZAT or PAT score is considered for the admissions. However, we would like you all to know that we will not start a Mumbai center this batch. What difficulties, challenges faced during your training period? How you deal with the same? So we have not started working yet. However, I'm quite confident of not facing any major challenges. Do keep in touch with us so that we can answer this to you in future. So, moving to the next slide. It'll be taken by Kunal.
Yeah, thank you, Mamita. So regarding the first question asked by Akshay, that is faculty and placement percentages. So I would say for every three students, there is one faculty because we have in-house faculties and some of the faculties that are visiting faculties and which gives us a great exposure to the industry and how the system is working there. So we get the business knowledge also from them. Regarding the placement percentages, till now, 84% of the batch has already been placed and still the placement team is assisting them. As Vipul has mentioned that Vedanta has visited online and tomorrow there will be interviews for two of the students and placement procedure is still going on for the current batch. So how good is the program and placement assistance? So I have, generally, for all those students, whether he is from Bangalore or Kolkata, the placement assistance remains the same. And for both the batches, the same number of companies visits. The success rates of getting the placement on completion of the course, I would say we have just finished the course and around 85% have already been placed. So, and looking at the seniors stat, I would say that 93% to 95% it is there. Giving you some stats about the CTC, the highest CTC for our batch was 22 approx. The median was around 9, average was 9.8, and the minimum was 6. So this was the CTC stats for our batch. Looking at the Kolkata based companies, around 6 to 7 companies were based out of Kolkata or who have provided jobs in Kolkata. What is the batch strength? So we have two batches, one is in Kolkata and one is Bangalore, and around 40 is the batch strength. Talking about me, how satisfied I am with the faculty for the analytics, I would definitely say that I am completely satisfied and as whatever I was looking for, more knowledge and the base foundation, Praxis has delivered that. So according to me, it is worth investment as per my experience and all. So passing it to the next to Vipul for understanding the more of the program highlights.
Yeah, thank you, Kunal. So now we will just briefly go through the data science program over here. Next slide, please. Basically the entire program is of 9 months duration divided into three individual terms. It is a full-time classroom training program. And pedagogy-wise, it is a completely instructor-led classroom training. It has a combination of lectures, case study discussions, projects, and labs. In terms of projects, we have many mini projects along with the particular subject domain areas. And in the final term, there is a big capstone project that encompasses the entire learning, whatever we have starting from the program till the very end of it. And we get to apply all those concepts in a very real world kind of scenario in capstone project. For example, I will tell you my capstone project. It was regarding a smart traffic management system. Basically, we intend to basically capture the traffic video from each side of the lane of a intersection, road intersection, and based on the vehicle density, we will automate the traffic signal timings. So suppose one side has a higher vehicle density and one side has a lower density, then the timing will be increased for the side that has higher vehicle density. So this was a very brief overview of our project. So next, batch schedule. So basically here there will be two batch schedules, one starting from January and ending by October. And the second is the July batch that starts in the July till March end. And the placement schedules is like that. For the July batch, it will be near around November. The day zero starts in the November, a particular date is fixed. And then it continues till the March and April of the next year. For the January batch, it will be starting at June and ending in the November. Next slide, please. Talking more about the course curriculum being delivered here in Praxis Business School. This is basically divided into four parts. There are techniques, tools and technologies, management concepts, and domain application. So within techniques, we have various techniques like machine learning, statistical modeling, deep learning, data visualization, text analytics, natural language processing. These are the basic things. In terms of tools and technologies, we'll be using RDBMS, SQL, and languages like Python, R, SAS. For visualization, we got to use Tableau and various inbuilt modules of Python like Matplotlib, Seaborn, and Plotly. And for the big data, we have Hadoop, Spark, and again, NoSQL, MongoDB. And in terms of for deep learning, we have TensorFlow and Keras API. In terms of management concept, we have the basic understanding of all the different various business analytics, be it in marketing analytics, finance analytics, telecom analytics, web analytics, analytics for healthcare, analytics in HR, all the fields were covered. And domain wise, it is already being covered for each particular domain. And the particular concept like market research was dealt separately. And there were other courses also like optimization techniques and managerial communication, all these. Moving on to the next section now, I would like to hand over to Soumya.
Next slide, please. Thank you, Vipul. So this is the student profile and student stats of our batch. Basically, in our batch, there were students from all the different graduates, from engineering graduates, there were students from different colleges, including IITs, NITs, PITs, VIT, SRM, every name it, and there were a lot of different colleges they were from. Non-engineering graduates were also there from the colleges like DSC, Hindu, Hansraj, CU, Symbiosis, Christ, etc. So our batch was a group of heterogeneous people. 30% of the batch are postgraduates, and 50% of these postgraduates were MBAs, and the rest are from math, stats, and technology background, including IIMs, IITs, NITs, BIT, TAPMI, etc. And this is the student profile for the experience and freshers. So there were around 11% freshers in the student background. Work experience of up to 2 years, there were around 20% students. Work experience of between 2 years to 5 years, there were around 54% students. And the work experience of more than 5 years, there were around 15% of the students in our batch. So majority of the students come from IT information technology background, from organizations such as Accenture. I was from Accenture, Capgemini, Infosys, TCS, Wipro, etc. All the big companies. So there are a lot of students who came from these companies. So next slide. Handing over to Kunal.
Yeah, so just giving a quick takeaways around the placement program. So as already I have discussed the CTC stats, generally for this year, for day zero is the first day on which the companies generally come to the college and they will be recruiting. So this time the 16 companies were there and compared to the last time that was 11. The process started at 5:30 a.m. in the morning, where IDFC Bank and Colgate were the first, and PwC were the first one. And it goes till the end of the day. And this was the screenshot of all the companies that visited that day and their allotted slots at the time that when they visited. So that happened on 11th November 2019. So that was our day zero. And then not only that, after that also a lot of companies visited, and this is our Superset app from on which there will be different, all the companies that are coming will be enlisted here and the students can apply from here. So these all are the companies that visited on day zero and after that.
So I'll be taking over this, Momita Ghosh. So we really understand your queries related to COVID. And knowing Praxis, we are quite sure that Praxis will go strict as per the instructions of the MHA, both in terms of when in-class sessions can start, plus what are the precautions to be taken in the start in-class sessions. It will be health and safety above all. Now, regarding the placement during this time, placements may be better, the same or worse, but one thing we can say as part of the PlaceCom that Praxis will move heaven and earth to place its students. Batch on batch placements have improved and we feel post-corona demand for data science may actually go up, but it's actually too early to say. Now, passing over to Vipul for the next questions.
Yeah, thank you, Momita. Moving on to the next section, proceeding to the next slide. How do I start the learning process? So the first question, like, what are the best tools and resources for a beginner in machine learning? Yeah, in terms of tools and resources, the absolute must is a Python. Means you must, as you start learning data science, you must know Python language. Earlier it used to be R, but the current popular language for data science area is Python. Apart from that, to extract data, one needs to have basic SQL query knowledge. And then further on, moving on to say you go on to the advanced level of data science, you move on to deep learning, you need various other tools like TensorFlow, but don't worry about that, that will come later on. And these are the basic tools you all need. Next question, what will be my step-by-step learning process to get into data science for beginners? For absolute beginners, I would say just start reading about statistics, basic statistics, and just try your hands on the Python language. These two things are very important, and as you develop a know-how of how these things work, how you get a better command on the Python language and get to know more about the statistics, you will develop an interest and then get to know the different concepts about that, and it will help you a lot. Further on, there are additional tools and additional concepts that you need to learn. that will come naturally to you. For absolute starting point, I would say statistics and Python. These are the two things. Important techniques. Yeah, as already said now, statistics and Python. Major skills languages required to get well placed. Yes. Speaking about skills, you need to have complete understanding of statistics. This is for getting placed towards the end of the curriculum. And you need to know Python language know-how and a bit of SQL query language, various concepts of machine learning. That will and some additional of all the various additional concepts like data visualization and deep learning. Those are optional, but you can have them. It will be advantageous for you for getting placed. Next section, please. Yeah. Now I would like Kunal to take in the next part, please.
Yeah. So now we have received few of the questions during our webinar. So we'll be answering them. So as I have received one of the question from Atul, I am 8 years of experience banking sales professional with non-technical background and no relative knowledge of maths, stats or data science. How hard will be this course for me and whether I will be able to complete course and get a job of increment on or the same salary job? How challenging will be the placement for me? Okay, so see Atul, looking at your profile, you have vast experience in banking, and we have and some of the companies that are visiting are like HSBC, ICICI, which you will have a major advantage as you know the business, how the business runs there. So you will have an advantage and edge over the others as per the business profiles. Regarding the maths and stats and data science, you will be learning here in this course from end to end, and you will have the hands-on. So I think this course is pretty good for you, and you can, as you already have the background experience of banking and sales, so you can opt for that. And as you know that the average salary is around 9.5, 9.8, so I think you can land up pretty good in those numbers. Okay, taking to the next question, the Sri Satya has asked, do companies recruit only recent graduates with 2-3 years of experience only? So I have 12 years of experience in supply chain and wanted to do PGDM. So first of all, I would like to highlight that this is a PGP BS course, post-graduation program in data science. That is a certificate program. Also, the recruiters that generally come doesn't come for like experience or fresher. They don't differentiate between them. So it is basically like for whole of the batch, and you will, if you have experience, that certainly matters, but it will not be a edge breaker. Some of the companies might come for freshers, some of the companies might only come for experience. So that depends on the company's profile and their job description. Then how Rakesh has asked, how will the program structure and what kind of extra efforts are required for students that is approaching to utilize the max out of the program? So Rakesh, that is a very good question. And I would say, see, 9 months is not too much time to cover the complete course. So you will have to put a lot of efforts from your end. So I would suggest like whenever the courses are going in the class, you should be on top of that. And then you should be studying apart from that to different sites like Analytics Vidya, then Kaggle, and try different problems on that. Also, like there are mastering machine learning and all, there are different online sites also, which you can try apart from the classes. Whatever doubts you are getting there, you can definitely approach to the faculties, and they are very approachable. Whatever doubts you are having, they will be very happy to clear that and discuss what your way of thinking, what you are thinking to solve those problems. How does the industry assign work compared to the academic learning? That is, are there specific additional aspects to learn during the program to be industry ready? So discussing on this, so we have faculties who are visiting directly from the industries, like for finances, for marketing and all, and they share their experience, like how the industry runs on their end. So we get to know what are the current real-time problems and how to solve them, and what are the perspective that the client would require. So that is that they certainly deliver. So I would pass to Soumya to answer the next of the questions.
Okay, I've got few questions. Starting from the first one, Hari Krishnan asked, for a fresher mechanical engineer, is it better to study data science and try to get into a job, or first get into a job in mechanical and then study data science? So, as mentioned in our slides earlier by Kunal, that we had many students in our batch who were from mechanical background, and Baramsukar was from mechanical background and was a fresher, got into a very good company with one of the highest package, and he got into a finance domain. So yeah, that's I don't think having a experience into that domain and then moving on to a data science field would help that much. But if you have a very much interest in data science and want to continue, so you should definitely go for it now. Being a fresher, it doesn't matter that much. Next question I got from Pratik. When is Praxis Business School's Mumbai batch going to start? So yeah, as mentioned by Momita, this year we won't be starting Mumbai batch because of COVID-19. Next question. I got one question. Is there any personal interview round before getting into Praxis? And if yes, what panelists want us to know basically? So yes, like all other MBA colleges, Praxis also has their own personal interview round. And panelists basically ask about your past experience, your domain knowledge, whatever you have worked. They ask all things about that thing only, so that they can know what you have learned throughout this year, what you have experienced throughout this year. So as such, they don't expect that you should have a predefined or pre-knowledge of data science, but whatever you have worked, your past experience, they will ask those things about those things. Next question, Veera Malu asked, our practice session happen in classroom itself? And during practice, if we get doubts, how can we help? So Praxis basically prefers more hands-on than going for the theory part. But mostly, if they take for a certain class, they will take 1 hour theory session, and again, the next hour would be the practice session. So it will happen in the classroom itself. And whatever the doubts you are getting or facing, it will be cleared that time only in that particular session. So yeah, you will not face any issue regarding clearing your doubt. Next question, Sukriti. I saw the course module. Isn't it too vast for 9 months? Is everything covered in such a short span? Yeah, so as you know, the course module is very vast and it's quite difficult. But I assure you that all the parts, all the objective and all the subjects are covered in this 9 months. Though it would be, the difficulty level would be quite high. You have to work really hard to learn all these concepts and work on it and get do the applications and everything. But I definitely assure you that 9 months is definitely sufficient for this course. Yedugani asked me one question. I got admission in Praxis Bangalore for July 2020 batch. Okay, so yeah, so congratulations for that. Hopefully, see you in the campus when we come back. Yeah, so handing over to Vipul if he has some questions.
Yeah, thank you, Soumya. So first question to me is from Pankaj Kalla. Yeah, we have a repeat question here. The question is, I have total 8 years of experience in automotive industry and have family. When I told my father that I will leave job and join Praxis, he was speechless. Suppose if I join back clearing all rounds and do the course, but how recruiters will find confidence in recruiting the guy like 8 years of experience? What is placement scenario in Praxis for experience in between 8 to 10 years? Very difficult for me to take decision, please guide.
Yeah, Soumya, so to answer his question, I would say like it is really a difficult question, but you should always look for what you like. And if you have passion for data science and if you are unable to devote time in that and you want to do the course, then certainly you will get a job. So that won't be an issue. If you have the passion for that, then you can surely go for that. But if you have some kind of hiccup, if you have some dilemma, then I would surely say you should think one more time if there is any kind of difficulty that you're facing. But if you have passion, then I would surely say Praxis is good as per my experience. As I'm having 6 years of experience and I joined Praxis and I certainly got the job before ending the curriculum. Hello. Am I audible?
Yes, yes, you are audible.
Yeah. So, Momita, can you go for the next questions?
Yes, I'll. So,
if you have any.
So, one question from Veera Malu. He asked that. During the 9 months of program at Praxis, are the classes recorded so that if I want to review it at a later date, if I get a doubt? So actually, we do not have the classes are not recorded, the classroom sessions. However, the professors are always available for you to clear your doubts. However, due to COVID, there will be online classes which will be recorded and you can go through it later. During the courses, another question from Veera Malu itself. During the course, do the students get evaluated in between to know the value of concepts understanding? Yes, we do get evaluated. As mentioned, it's a trimester course. We have a concept of midterm and end term, therefore helping us to test our knowledge in between. Question from Gaurangi. Will there will be any impact of Corona on this year's Jan and July batch placement? So we don't think it will be, as we are already, as our placement coordinator is already talking with the companies and and asking them. However, the college may start late for you, like the July batch may be postponed from August and something like that. So for that, the placements will also be postponed and maybe the number of companies will be coming a little less, but it won't be an issue. Question by Chandrashish. Hi, could you please tell me the placement stats again for your batch? So for the July 1920 batch, we had an average package of 9.8 lakhs, median of 9, and highest of 22.1 lakhs. The percentage, 84% of the students were placed for that batch. Next question is hospitality management. So yeah, we actually had a guy who did his post-graduation in hospitality from TIS and he has been doing pretty well and he is placed in Nihilan now. What will be the placement scenario for non-IT background? So it's actually, there is no, the placement is same for all of the batch, the students of the batch. Everyone gets an equal opportunity to apply to the companies that are coming in. So you need not worry about being from a non-IT background. Next question is from Chandrashish. Is there a limitation on the number of companies a student applies for placement? So before day zero, there is no actual limitation in the number of companies you apply. However, on day zero, once you are placed in one company, like the first company you are placed, you cannot sit for the other companies that are in the queue. So yeah, that's all the questions that I have from my end.
Thank you, Momita. So a few of the questions that were there is like Gorangi asked, is there any difference between the placement for Jan and July batches, also for Bangalore and Kolkata campuses? So mostly there are no differences between Bangalore and Kolkata campus. The companies visits both the campuses at the same time. Regarding January and July batches, so it depends on the company's availability and their hiring process. Some of the companies might prefer January batch and some of the companies might prefer July batch, but more than 60% of the companies are visiting to both. Also, there is a question from Atul. If I have decided to join Praxis for July batch, do we have any pre-preparation study material for the students so that they can pace up other tech students? So Atul, my advice would be you can go through for pre-preparation, you can go through the basic of statistics, linear algebra and Python. Rest other things will be covered in the classes. So if you are on top of that, then I don't think so much of the issues will be there. Then Shalendra has asked, can I get some suggestions how to use these 2 months of time before starting the course? So as I already said, you focus on the stats, Python, and building the concepts, and I think that will be enough. I have a question from Arnab. I have 7 years of experience in power plant operation, and I am a engineer auditor as well. Is there any company hiring from energy domain? So it is not right now, but several alumni have worked in such projects while being employed with consulting firms like PwC, EY, Fractal, and Deloitte. So, Soumya, do you have any additional questions on this?
No, Gunal, you have answered. Gelugani also asked the same question, that how can I use these 2 months to prepare for the college. So yeah, as mentioned by Kunal, you can study the basics of Python, SQL and stats. But other than that, Praxis teaches everything from scratch anyway. So it would be an added advantage if you study the basics. So yeah, that's it.
Okay. Thank you. So any other questions that are there, you can surely pitch in to the host, and he will be directing it to us. So I got a question from Kavya. In this phase, as we have a lot of time to prepare ourselves for the course, what are the basic fundamentals we need to concentrate? How are we supposed to practice them? And what is the regime you followed to excel in this course? So Kavya, basically starting with the fundamentals, the base is mostly, if you start with stats, because that is the basics, and linear algebra, because that will be needed, and Python programming. Once you are through it, take any kind of projects that are available on Kaggle or any other like machine learning mastery. And from that, you can go and try to solve it and creating the hypothesis. And then if you are able to crack that up and learn the models and all, then well and good, that will be, that's it. Like basic level of data science, you will be able to cover it by yourself. But the main problem with data science is like, this is a very vast domain, and we need a bit of handholding that we don't get lost in this. So it's better like if you join a course, and so that way you can get a good guidance on that. So for me, I would say I used to practice from different books that was provided by the institute and the materials that they provided. Also, I had continuous talks with my faculty discussing about all my ideas that I was having and trying to how to bring it from the paper to the real world. So generally my practice sessions were like that. I have one more question from Pankaj. I have a total 8 years of experience in automotive industry. I think I answered this. Yeah, I think this question has been answered. So that's it from our end. Anyone else has any questions?
Yeah. One question I got from Vineshri. How many hours did you spend per day studying in class and outside class? So most of the days, mostly Monday to Saturday, you will be having a class of around 6 to 7 hours. And after that, I have studied for 2 hours basically every day, at least minimum 2 hours, so that you should understand what you have what you learned today in class and go revise it. That is always a good thing to do. And first semester was quite difficult because that is the time you have to learn all the basics and go move into advanced sections. So I focused a lot in the first semester, and after second semester, you start doing small projects and stuff. So it gets a bit easier, but not like our point of view, but you will be doing some projects. So it would be very interesting for you at the end of the day. So that's it, what I did. Any other questions, if you have, you can send us.
I have a question from Shubham. What is the process of joining the course? So we have an eligibility criteria, minimum of 60% marks in 10th, 12th and graduation. Graduation in engineering, statistics, mathematics, physics, economics, or any other with math as one of the subjects. The tests that are accepted are Praxis admission test, that is the PAT, CAT or ZAT, minimum 85% and above in quant and DI, and GMAT, that you need to score 650 and above, and GRE 320 and above. The selection process is profile based, shortlisting based on test score, academic performance, professional qualification, work experience, and the final selection basis performance in essay and personal interview. There's a question from Sukriti to Vipul. However, Vipul is disconnected from the call.
Yeah, I am here.
Okay.
I am unable to see the question. Can you just...
Yes, I'll read it out.
Read the question.
So she is asking that Vipul is from sales, but he said he also used to work on analytics little bit when he found his field interesting and thought of pursuing the course from Praxis. But I don't have any analytics knowledge in my profession. Will I face difficulty?
Yeah, so answering Sukriti, although I got to see the little bit of technology side, database side, but I couldn't understand a thing of it. Now when I see it, I know that they are writing basically SQL queries, SQL select queries, to develop the custom reports and custom forms. So no, you will not face any difficulty even though you do not have any analytics knowledge, as long as you have an interest and inclination towards learning the concepts and put in your hard effort, you will not face any difficulty. Rest assured, you will do well. So one more question here from Arnav Sinha. What is the average CTC offered by Kolkata-based analytics hirer? So yeah, the average CTC being offered by such companies are around 8 to 9 lakhs, which are based out of Kolkata. I would further like to ask if anyone has any further question, they can please send us the questions in the chat.
Yeah, thanks Vipul. So I have a question from Atul. He has asked, yeah, do placement company take 8 years experience as negative criteria, or there are any favorable criteria for placement companies like 3 to 4 years? So that Atul, that completely depends on the company that are visiting the campuses. Generally, it is 8 years is not taken as a negative, rather it will be taken as the positive for all the companies which are specific to that domain, because you are already having the business knowledge and now just you have to implement those business knowledge and combine it with the technology. So they don't have to teach you all the business that needs to be learned. So it will be taken as an advantage by the companies which are for which you already have the domain knowledge. There are no any favorable criteria for the placement, like a person should have 3 to 4 years of experience.
So thank you, Kunal. I have two questions here. One from Saurabh Patnaik. He asks, if someone has no experience, is he able to get a job with good package? So to answer you, Saurabh, let me give you example of our classmate Shiladitya, who has got a very good job with CTC of 17 lakhs. So that answers your question. Yeah. Irrespective of you having zero experience or many years of experience, it doesn't matter. As long as you are thorough with your concepts, you put in your effort, you know the basic things in data science, all the things, you do well in the interview, you will do well. Second question from Shivani, would this course be a degree or a diploma course? Basically, this is a postgraduate diploma course. The name itself, postgraduate diploma in data science. This was the last question for me. Any further questions?
Yeah, I have a question.
You can please.
I have done my bachelor's in pharmacy followed by 7.5 years in bank. So does company comes up with any filtered criteria that a person should be an engineer or so? So actually, companies do not have a criteria when it comes to academic background. However, some may have a criteria of job experience. That is, they might need a job ex of 2 years or above for application. But that is a very few companies have that. Most of the companies are open to all. That's it from my end.
Yeah, so anyone else have any questions? So I think all the questions
that I got one just now. Chitra has asked, having a career gap for 4 years due to valid reasons with experience of 2 years in IT, how do the companies screen their required candidates? Do they treat them a fresher? Okay. So, this year only, a lot of my friends were having a career gap in between. One of my friend was working with Accenture for 3 years, and then she had a gap of 1 or 2 years. And then she again joined the Praxis Business School. So, it does not matter as such that you have a career gap. Unless and until you have a past experience, that will definitely help you to get a job. And having a career gap doesn't impact that for placement. Any other question, if you guys have, you can send us.
Thank you, Soumya. I think we are done with the questions.
Yes.
Yeah. So the host will be sending the email links for our email links to you, so you can contact us. And then whatever query you have in future, we'll be definitely happy to answer those.
Kunal, I am getting one question here from Rakesh.
Yeah.
Rakesh asks, how does the placement program help experienced professionals 9 years from a manufacturing sector? Will the experience level of 9 years in non-IT industry be an obstacle? To answering that, no. Experience of 9 years in a non-IT industry will not be an obstacle. Rather, I would say for many companies, mainly from consulting domain, like the big four like PwC or Deloitte, they rather prefer to go for experienced guys. They see for it. If it is relevant to them, they will definitely pick it up. Whatever industry you come from, if definitely it has an application of data science, so they will be willing to take it. It will not be an obstacle. And in the day of the placement interview, you need to be thorough with your concept. They will be asking about you, your concepts, how well you do know them, and about your projects, what you are doing, how well you have done them. So you do well there, you will get the job. It will not be an obstacle. So that was the last question for me.
Yeah, thank you, Vipul.
Yeah.
So just one question that came up to me from YK. I wanted to know if there is no Mumbai batch, how shall the selection process for Mumbai students be conducted considering the current situation of pandemic and travel restrictions? So the students can join the Bangalore or Kolkata batch depending on your interest. The process will be online via Skype, the interview and aptitude test via Mettle. So you can give that test and see if you clear that out, then you are through. Till the this pandemic doesn't end, there will be online classes. So I think that won't be any issue. And once the classes resume, there will be a revision of all the concepts that has been taught. So there is one more question from Ashutosh Swen. I am belong to secondary research background. So how can data science will be helpful? So that is a good question, Ashutosh. Generally, you are from secondary research background. So here, when we try to do a capstone, we generally try to do something new and do some research on the papers that already, whatever has already been established. In that process, we write technical research papers, IEEE, which generally, which will be a completely new, and we learn how to present them in the conferences and all. So once, as we have written few of the papers, which are in IEEE formats, and that might get published once we'll send it for different publications. So being a research background, that will surely help in data science, because you have the ability, you have that capability and passion to research to research on the things that are already not there. So I think that will be really helpful for you. So I think that's it from our end. At last, I would thank all the participants to have their such a interest in participating in this webinar. We wish them all the best for their coming future, and we hope you all to see in future in Praxis and become a part of the Praxis family. We all are traveler in the path of excellence, and it would be great to have such great minds together. So thanking you all.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thanking all the participants.